Hello, basketball fans. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports, along with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. I'm Ernie Johnson. Tonight, it'll be the Chicago Bulls up against the Los Angeles Lakers. And for Los Angeles, let's just say it has not been a season to remember for them. With a large chunk of the schedule behind us, they have the worst record in the entire NBA. Yikes. And as we reach the midway point, Kenny, still a lot of games left on the schedule. How do players cope with the wear and tear their bodies go through?
Well, a lot of times when you're mentally or physically tired, you know, you could sit there and all of a sudden you misquote things, you missay things here on the analyst desk. On a basketball court, that's turnovers. That's missing assignments, missing rebounds. Same thing. Like, I know this is our, 82nd game this year? You're starting to feel a little bit? That's how those guys feel.
I didn't know the midpoint was the 82nd game. But anyway, injuries start to take a toll.
No, but we've done 82nd two games. Doesn't mean
we've done a lot of games in our role here.
I misunderstood. Two games a night, remember?
On the set. Yeah,
anyway, I was saying the injuries, they start to take a toll. Not just the big ones, the little ones. Type of injuries I hate are the freak injuries. One time, Ernie, I was walking with my shoes off, stubbed my toe.
That's called barefoot.
That's a freak injury. Stubbed my toe, was out for 6 weeks. So you got to get rest, eat well.
Well, if you kick a brick wall, knees, that's not a...
And man up.
Yeah. Maybe you should. Here's Kevin Harlan.
Oh, say does that star-spangled banner your way, o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
We're in the place they call the United Center in Chicago, the home of the Bulls, where today we'll be broadcasting live. We're happy to have you with us for 2K Sports midweek presentation of NBA basketball. I'm Kevin Harlan, and here with me today, Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony.
Ready?
You take a look at Los Angeles. These guys really need a win. Very frustrating right now. Look at guys, 0-9 to start this season.
Yeah, and they're coming in this game also looking for payback after dropping the last one. They play each other just twice this season, and they certainly do not want to be swept.
And you know how it is, Greg. You tend to remember the losses more than the wins. What might have gone differently when you've lost a game? You feel a lot better when you can answer back with a win, but you got to earn it.
All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. Taking a look at the Lakers. They've got Anderson. Olajuwon is out there with LaMarcus Aldridge. Then it's Cheeks. And it's Morris in at the small forward. Bulls on D. It's a three-point game. Their last game, a win against San Antonio, looking to carry that into this one.
I think everyone who saw that game would just have to agree it was about what they could do defensively in terms of winning.
And I thought the activity was tremendous all over the court defensively. And that kind of hustle is going to pay off for you, and it also is going to keep your coach happy.
Now, here is Morris. After the miss by Oscar Robertson. Morris into the lane. Just 5 to shoot. It's up and it's off the mark. He's 0 for 1. The Lakers on D. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to the Raptors.
And really, given how they performed offensively, guys, they just never had a chance.
Yeah, and you can see their frustration growing and growing as they continued to come up empty on their possessions. By the end, they were just happy to watch the clock wind down and move on.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
Robertson outside. No good on the triple.
Still scoreless after 4 attempts, trying to take the lid off the basket.
Robertson against Cheeks. No good. Now Chicago takes it the other way. They went to Los Angeles for their last meeting with the Lakers and came out with a victory.
It seems odd to say, given that they won that pretty easily, but really, they did not look especially strong in that game.
Yeah, and if there wasn't a scoreboard around, you would have thought it was a lot closer than it ended up being.
The Bulls shooting their first free throw attempt on the night.
At the line for the Bulls, one shot.
And Robertson, no good on that one. The Lakers have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Dishes to Elijah Wan, and he takes that one up and powers it through.
Heads up play there, guys, on the assist and the finish.
Robertson kicks to Green. Back to Robertson. Makes no mistake on the open jump shot.
And a really good way to start the game. He's a guy who, if he gets it going early, he's going to give you problems.
Anderson with the ball. Last time out, he had 13 points. Picked by Elijah Wan. Sheik's no good.
Hey, they got the shot they wanted off of that pick, but it just doesn't fall.
Yeah, it didn't go down, but you'll take that shot every single time, Greg. That's good offense.
Now here's Robertson. A 14-point game for him in the win against San Antonio.
And how about the extraordinary display of his passing in that game? He was making all the right decisions and had their offense humming.
Aldridge's shot is good.
It is so hard to contain him. He just seems to get it done however he has to do it.
And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, Robertson passes to Parrish. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. It's going to be on Hakeem Olajuwon. Chicago shooting their second and third free throws tonight.
And typically a strength of theirs, 79% on the season.
Yeah, guys, they can feel very good about themselves when you bring up those statistics. Impressive numbers.
Both free throws good from Parrish. For Los Angeles, they've gone 3-7 from the field since we've gotten underway. Aldridge, the pass to Cheeks. And the pass to Morris. Here's Cheeks. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Raptors in Toronto.
And he also was a table setter in that game, Kevin. Just an amazing job with his passing. Just a joy to watch that one.
Just 5 on the clock. The Lakers in the lead. From deep.
Nothing dropping for him, so I think in the best interest of his team, he may need to think about not shooting right now. It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
Parrish against Aldridge. Launches it, and that one's good.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
Los Angeles has gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Robertson against Cheeks. Pass to Elijah Wan. Fades and shoots. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron.
Really nice work inside there. He'll always give you a battle on the interior, guys.
Robertson outside. From about 19 feet, the rebound by Anderson.
It's not winning basketball when you're attempting shots like that.
Yeah, come on now. You got to remember, it's a team game. He's got four teammates out there with him. I don't think he needs to try to do it all by himself like that.
Man, how about that one-man fast break?
I love the power finish at the end of it, too.
Lakers have gone 4-for-9 from the field to start this game off. Hudson against Aldridge. Aldridge a screen. Elijah Wan dishes to Morris. And again, no good by the Lakers.
Yeah, but the hand in the face. It's critical that you contest his shots every time down the floor.
Off target with his three. The Lakers trail. Cheeks kicks to Morris. Elijah Wan with a screen on Hughes. Hughes against Morris. Picked by Elijah Wan. Five to shoot. High arcing shot, and there's the play by Morris inside.
I like it. I like it. He broke out the fancy finish there.
And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Well, when Byron Scott and I had a chance to catch up a few minutes ago, in the first meeting, he said that he didn't feel his team was as sharp as they needed to be in their offensive sets, and that is what cost them the game. He told me, if we can take care of the ball and execute in the half court like I know we're capable of, it puts us in a much better position to win against this team. Let's see if that's the case.
Doris, thanks. Guys, shooting is a chief concern for them.
And if that is the focus, then their ball movement is going to have to be sharp today.
It's very rare that you see a team shoot the ball well without moving it well. And that's the hidden message when the coach talks about their shooting. Now we've got a moment to see how the Bulls are doing rank-wise in the NBA. Second in fewest turnovers per game. Third in steals. And they're the third-ranked fast break team in the league. I mean, there's always that fear that they're going to run you off the court when you play them. You got to get back in transition against this team.
And you got to love how well they safeguard their offensive possessions. You see the ranking. Second fewest turnovers committed. Terrific ball handling and smart passing.
Tony Allen's checked in for the Lakers. Stockton comes in for Cheeks. Rubio the pass to Green. Rubio outside. Pass to Sabonis. The rebound by Anderson.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
Allen dishes to Stockton. They set the pick. He feeds it to Anderson. That's good. And a nice assist from Stockton. And the Lakers lead by two.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
And Rubio kicks to Green. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Green's got his first 3 points of the game.
That's the kind of D that you're not going to find success with, guys. They've got to get a hand in the face.
Now Stockton. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. And Anderson gets it to go.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play.
Now, here's Rubio. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Sabonis, the pass to Rubio. There's the pick. Here's Hughes. He dishes it to Hudson. Passes it to Green. Lets it go from deep. That doesn't go either for Green.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for Los Angeles.
You know what, guys? It looks to me like they're really in sync here, all on the same page. They've already got a bunch of assists.
Yeah, they're showing some muscle also in the first half as well, and getting a lot of their points in the paint. Really like the balance they've shown.
Andre Iguodala is checked in for Chicago. Ellis comes in for Larry Hughes. And then for Los Angeles, Andrew Bogut. He's checked in for Elijah Wan. Gibson comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. And Wilson Chandler subbed in for Anderson. Bulls trail by three. Inside, there's Sabonis, and it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line.
In that tight, with that much of an advantage height-wise, there's just not a lot the defense can do.
and he's got his first chance at the line here.
And he's at 73% this year at the foul line. Adequate, but not spectacular.
He's had trouble putting up the same numbers from the foul line that he put up last season.
Here is Stockton. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Bogut with a screen on Rubio. And Stockton, here we go. Iguodala with the steal. Fast break, here comes Chicago. Excellent D from Stockton.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Now, here's Bogut from seven. It's hauled in by the Bulls. Green's got his third rebound on the night. Rubio against Chandler. Rubio dishes to Ellis. Green with a screen on Allen. And it's Ellis penetrating. No luck. The Lakers have gone an even 50% from the field. They are 7 of 14 for the game. Stockton kicks to Chandler. And again, the Lakers no good. The Bulls shooting only around 32% so far in this one. The offense looking a bit off kilter. Sabonis. Rebound the Lakers.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
Gibson with a screen on Rubio. Stockton passes to Gibson. Cannot hit. Great D that time from Green. Now one against Rubio. And it's Ellis penetrating. That drops. And the Bulls lead by two.
He's got to be a little embarrassed for joining the Paratroopers Club on that pump fake.
Allen dishes to Stockton. Trying to find Chandler. He's got it now. That shot wide open. Chandler's got the game tied up here for the Lakers. Chicago with the ball. Rubio outside. Feeds it to Ellis. Green with a screen on Allen. Ellis kicks to Green. Five to shoot. His three-pointer's off the mark.
Oh, boy, I tell you what. They don't get much uglier than the quarter he's having.
Yeah, and it's not showing any signs, Greg, of turning around here soon. I mean, his touch has basically gone AWOL.
Now Stockton following the miss by Draymond Green from deep. Allen outside. Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here. No good off the front iron.
Rebounding is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
No, it always is, and it has been so far, and they've gotten a nice edge on the glass.
Now, here's Ellis. He's usually able to provide some lift to his team, averaging 6 points a game. And that one's good. Green's got five.
Gets one to fall, but only a second make in the first seven attempts.
Allen drives in. No good. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. Rubio outside. Back to Ellis. Now here's Iguodala. A 14-point game for him in the win against San Antonio. Outside Green. Tries it from 19. In it goes. That's his third bucket. He's missed five so far.
He's so tough to guard. He can fake you one way and then just spin right by you.
And here is Chandler. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. Screen by Bogut. And Chandler, here we go. And that concludes the first quarter of play. Bulls lead by four. And don't go away. We'll be back momentarily. Talk to Monte Ellis. He says he feeds off his doubters. He loves to hear someone say what he can't do.
I think I had that all my life. I always have to prove somebody wrong. And, you know, still to this day, that's just the competitiveness that I believe my oldest brother built into me when I was little.
And Monte Ellis is still trying to prove people wrong now in Dallas after their quick exit from the playoffs a season ago. Clark, it's been a decade in the league now for this very talented guard.
And, you know, that kind of relentless determination is really something Monte is known for and one of the reasons he has been around for 10 years in the NBA as a consistently good player and lethal scorer.
Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Bulls?
I just really like what we're seeing from a defensive standpoint, forcing a lot of turnovers with those quick hands.
Yeah, those active hands, Greg, have produced a number of steals early. They've been very aggressive.
Taking a look at the Lakers. Cheeks is out there with Jarrett Jack. Then it's Marcus Morris. Then it's Elijah Wan. And it's Aldridge in at the four spot. Now here's Robertson. Great open look there. Hudson's got his second bucket of the game to go. So it's the Lakers now. They trail by three. Jack against Robertson. To the paint. And Aldridge slams it in.
And guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't, Jay. You're right. A glaring error defensively and letting him get all the way to the basket that time.
But it's only 2 points. I mean, it was flashy, no doubt. But still, it only counts for two.
Two is all. And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, that's the message they were sending with that foul. Nothing easy inside.
Bulls shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game.
At the line for the Bulls, two shots.
The free throw drops for Robertson. Second free throw, no good. The Lakers trail. Kicks it to Aldridge. Elijah on with a screen on Robertson. Morris into the lane. The Lakers rebound. Aldridge wide open, he fires. And the go-ahead bucket, no good. Here's Chicago. Iguodala, the pass to Hughes. And again, no good by Chicago.
Well, I think the defense got lucky right there. I mean, he's going to make a lot more of those than he misses when he's got that much room.
Elbow shot is on the way. Andre Iguodala comes up with the rebound. Now the pass to Hughes. And there's the feed to Parrish. Pass to Hughes. Screen by Parrish. From the corner. No good from Robertson. The Lakers have gone 2 of 5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%. Robertson against Jack. Elijah with a screen on Robertson. Jack passes to Cheeks. Elijah kicks to Jack. Here's Aldridge. Offensive rebound. Elijah.
Oh! And surprisingly, a firm throwdown. And that's a little bit out of character, Kevin.
It is, Greg. You're right. He's got plenty of size to attack the basket, but Clark rarely does.
Well, he certainly attacked it that time, Kevin. I mean, that's what they want to see more from him.
And that last replay, courtesy of Kia.
Yeah, just frustrated by their lack of production offensively, and I can't blame them. I mean, they're getting the looks, but the shots just aren't falling.
Yeah, and the slump that they're having shooting the ball can take its toll on you if you're not mentally strong. So I like this time out here to try to get those guys reset and refocused.
find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Thanks, guys. I was able to hear Byron Scott coaching his team during the break. The focus of the discussion was getting their offense to run through LaMarcus Aldridge. Their offense's most effective, coach said, when he is most involved. And they're looking for total involvement from him for the rest of this game. They're not going to wait for halftime. They want those adjustments to have an impact right away. Over to you, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris.
And ran his man straight into the screen and got a clear path to the bucket.
That is how it is done.
Excellent team play there on the pick, and then he ripped it down.
In the corner, it's Morris. It's hauled in by the Bulls. Robertson's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Poke loose. Here's Hudson, the 11-footer. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him. Now it's a 4-point Bulls lead for Los Angeles. They've gone 3 of 8 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. Lakers passing it around. Aldridge sets up the pick now for Jack. Fires at the elbow. No luck. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. Robertson kicks to Parrish. Back to Robertson. All alone. Nice jump shot. Good. Robertson's got his 3rd bucket of the night.
That's their 3rd straight make off an assist.
Great ball movement.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a 3-point play. So Jack will go to the free throw line. They get Andre Iguodala. The Lakers have gone 2 for 2 in the game at the line.
And collectively, they're only about 73% as a unit right now.
Guys, their free throw shooting has slipped a bit since last year, but not really to the point where they should be overly concerned about it.
And Jared Jack, no good on that one. The Bulls leading by 4. Screen by Parrish. Robertson drives in. It's stolen by Jack. The dish to Elijah Wan. That one goes in for him, too, making it look easy. He's now 4 for 4.
Well, he knew how many inches he had over the guy. I mean, let's face it, good decision to just rise up and take the jump shot.
On the wing, Iguodala tries it from 19. Again, Chicago.
Well, guys, they've shown some great passing on their last few trips now on the floor. Excellent.
4 straight passes leading to scores. Great team play.
Now, here is Jack. It's rebounded by Robertson. Robertson's got 4 rebounds now tonight. The 15-footer. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
He just has not been able to get into that groove yet, guys. But as a whole, it hasn't affected them too much.
Here's Jack. Finds the hole for the second time from the floor. Now 2 for 5.
And look, he's not the best athlete, but he's able to create the space he needs to operate.
Dishes to Hudson. Back to Robertson. The shot is off. Jack with the defensive effort. He kicks to Aldridge. Cheeks against Iguodala. Pass to Elijah Wan. And Jack, here we go. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. Here we are in November, and let's see how things are going out east in the early season. Taking a look at Washington, they've got the number 1 record in the conference, and because of it, each night out, their competition is going to bring it right at them. And, of course, the Chicago Bulls, 5 games behind.
And, you know, for the Bulls, they've stayed right there, just in sniffing distance of the conference leaders. That's a solid accomplishment at this stage of the season.
You know, I thought maybe they'd have it in them to actually join those leaders this season. But you're right, it's still nice work considering where they are.
All right now, gentlemen, 2 shots. 2 shots.
Free throw drops for Jarrett Jack. So for the Bulls. Green comes in for Andre Iguodala. And Ricky Rubio subbed in for Larry Hughes. The Lakers also making some changes. Andrew Bogut checked in for Olajuwon. Gibson comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. And Tony Allen subbed in for Cheeks. And it's tied up with that one.
You know, he didn't get to the line in that entire first quarter. But right now, he's showing some aggressiveness out there.
Rubio dishes to Hudson. Parrish with the screen on Allen. Here's Hudson. And again, no good by Chicago. Lakers have gone 6 of 13 so far from the field here in the second quarter. And Jack, here we go. Here's Gibson. And he banks in the layup.
I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
That's got to be job number one right now. Nothing easy on the inside.
Now here's Robertson. He has seven. Parrish kicks to Robertson. Out to the right wing. Parrish, the pass to Hudson. Here's Rubio. It's hauled in by Bogut.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
Allen outside. Rubio against Jack. And the shot no good, a bit short. Bulls have gone 5 of 12 from the field here in the second. Robertson against Anderson. He had a nice open look right there. Rubio's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Jack dishes to Anderson. Back to Jack. And it's stolen by Ricky Rubio. Oh, and a fast break for the Bulls. And the wide open shot from Green. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
Even with every shot clanging off the rim, he seems determined to keep hoisting up these threes. It might be time to get inside of that arc.
Jack missing again. Chicago leading. Screen by Parrish. The drive by Rubio. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in. Rubio's got 5 points so far. Anderson up top, covered by Robertson. Jack against Rubio. Right side Jack, 5 on the clock. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two. Robert Parrish picks one up there. And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Chicago.
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
You know, we've seen them bearing their fair share of mid-range jumpers tonight, too. I mean, that's a good start for them.
And the first one at the line is good.
Boy, they're really battling, guys. Not sitting back, being aggressive, attacking when they have the chance. I like that.
Man, I like their approach to the game right now. There's tremendous aggression on both ends, putting the onus on the officials.
John Stockton, he's checked in for the Lakers. And Jarrett Jack drops them both.
There's not a lot you can say that hasn't been said before about his skill at the charity stripe.
And Rubio kicks to Hudson. Right wing. Here's Sabonis. Nails the 16-footer. 5 points in the game.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
Just beautiful when they play the game like this.
Now here's Allen. He feeds it to Gibson, tries it from 19. That's good on the jump shot. Gibson's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And not a great start for him in the first, but he's quickly starting to turn it around.
Hudson against Allen. Here's Hudson. He's coming off a 31-point game against San Antonio.
And gotta like what they've been doing down low in the post.
I certainly do. You know, I like to see guys do their work inside. Their rebounding has been excellent,
And that's always important in a close game.
Now here's Gibson. Here's Allen. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Over the last 10 games, Kevin, you can see where the Lakers rank in the league right now. 10th in free throw percentage. 12th in blocks. Contesting shots, though, not something they do well. Only top 20 in the league in opponent field goal percentage.
Yeah, and getting back to their free throw percentage, you know, it might seem like a small thing, but sometimes it's those little things that can put a team over the top.
The Lakers have made six of their seven attempts at the line in this one. Ties it up, and this next one could give them the lead. Los Angeles making a switch here. Chandler's checked in. And the free throw is good, now leading by one. Chicago has gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Passes it to Sabonis. Green, the screen. Green with a screen on Bogut.
Yes!
Feeds it to Hudson. Six on the shot clock. He dishes it to Rubio. The three ball. Chandler with the rebound. Lakers shooting 44% from the floor since we began the second quarter. And that one's good, Ellis. Well, guys, this first half has been about as tightly contested as you could hope for.
Well, neck and neck, how about that? I mean, ferociously competitive. I mean, tight as me in an airplane bathroom.
That's not the visual I was looking for right now, but there have been a lot of lead changes. My goodness.
No good from Bogut.
Well, he gets it in close, but you have to credit that stifling defense for forcing the miss.
Exactly, Greg. I mean, defense like that really increases the degree of difficulty on that shot by a large amount.
The Bulls shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight.
At the line for the Bulls, two shots.
First free throw is good. He's perfect from the line this time. Lakers trail by three. Stockton passes to Chandler. Kicks it to Bogut. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Two shots.
Shooting two. Shooting two.
The first free throw is good. Marcus Morris has checked in for Taj Gibson. So he's able to get one of two. Chicago's gone 1-4 from three-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Right side, Green. It's stolen by Bogut. Rubio against Chandler. From the baseline.
That's his second personal foul. If he gets another, it probably puts him on the bench for the rest of the first half.
The Lakers have shot 9 of 11 at the free throw line.
Chicago. Marcus Morris. Two shots.
Okay, gentlemen, two shots. Two shots.
Oh, Free throw good from Morris. And Morris drops them both. They time it right. They can end this quarter with a 2-for-1.
And that's how you want to end the quarters.
Fires it up. A nice shot by Hudson. Hudson's got 6 in the quarter.
And fellas, in this quarter, he's improved on what was already a very good performance in period number 1.
Green against Chandler. Bangs home the trifecta. Chandler's got 5 points so far.
Just so many lead changes. Nobody's held an advantage for long.
Well, the runs have just been traded back and forth all game long. Man, I'm enjoying this.
Green, the screen. No good from Hudson.
It's not winning basketball when you're attempting shots like that.
Yeah, come on now. You got to remember it's a team game. He's got 4 teammates out there with him. I don't think he needs to try to do it all by himself like that.
And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. Lakers on top, leading by 3. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Well, Ricky, what does it say about this team to have such great productivity from the bench? And what does it do for you guys as a unit?
It's amazing. That means, like, we have a deep bench and then a lot of work from the staff, from everybody of the team, like doing extra work and winning games.
Well done, Ricky. Thank you. Guys, back to you.
Okay, Doris, much appreciated. And now for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hi again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here, joined by Shaq and Kenny the Jet. Welcome to the halftime show on 2K Sports. A competitive matchup for the Lakers in the first quarter. The biggest lead of the quarter was only 3 points as they traded baskets back and forth. They played with more purpose in the second quarter and fought to turn an early deficit into a 3-point lead by the time we reached the break. And let's get your thoughts, Kenny, on the Lakers.
The differential is the free throw attempts. And that's one of the big stories in this game tonight. They were being so aggressive and so smart that all they could do on the defensive end was foul.
And Shaq, what'd you think about Chicago?
Their 3-point shooting in the first half was atrocious. Ugh, ugly, awful, nasty. It's not that they're just missing shots. It's like they just keep taking the shots. Hold on, Ernie. Hey, you, whatever your number is, stop shooting the 3. See, Ernie, that's all the coach got to do. Tell him stop shooting the 3. Pass, cut, work together, do something.
And now, folks, it's just about time for the third quarter to begin. We will see you after the final buzzer.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. We're seeing a tremendous game from LaMarcus Aldridge.
Yeah, created a lot of quality shots for himself in that first half, and he knew when to pass it up when the double team came.
And that led to a very high points per shot number for him. For those of you that are into analytics, that stat really tells how efficient a player has been, and he's been very efficient so far.
Parrish is out there with Draymond Green. Then it's Larry Hughes. Then there's Hudson. And it's Robertson in at the point. So that's the 5 in the game for Chicago. Cheeks against Hughes. Here's Cheeks. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Near the 3-point line, it's Morris. And it's Chicago with the rebound. Following this one, they get to host the Cavaliers. And that'll be the 3rd of the 4 straight at home.
Nice move and finish. I think the halftime break really gave him a second win.
The Lakers in the lead. Cheeks kicks to Aldridge. There's the pass to Elijah Wan. Fades back. No good. And it's Chicago the other way. Here's Hughes. Elijah Wan grabs the miss. The Lakers shooting a mediocre 41% in this one. Picked by Elijah Wan. Here's Cheeks. And he gets the bucket. Cheeks has got the lead up to three now for the Lakers.
Really aggressive play there, taking it to the rack against the big fella.
You know, Greg, aggressiveness is really the only option when you're on the wrong side of the size equation.
And out of bounds as the Lakers gain possession. Lakers leading by three. Anderson passes to Cheeks. And the rejection by Parrish.
That's one for their first four to start the second half.
Pass to Hughes. To the right side. Parrish against Aldridge. Parrish kicks to Robertson. And again, no good by Chicago.
Oof, rough shooting night tonight, but you can't fault him for the effort.
That's going to be over and back, not watching for the line that time.
Oh, no, you hate to see that. Those are just the kind of errors that can cost you in a game like this.
Andre Iguodala, he's checked in for Hudson. Here is Robertson, 7 points in the game. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. There's a good screen. Parrish kicks to Robertson. Tries from the block, and that's off the glass and in. Robertson's got 9.
And that's what you want to see. Good, fundamental, sound basketball with the bounce pass.
Quickest hands in the league. The Bulls third.
You can't get careless with the basketball against this group. I mean, they'll pick your pocket, and no surprise to see them in the upper echelon as far as steals.
A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Picked by Olajuwon. Cheeks against Robertson. The feed now to Olajuwon. 16 feet away. And the rejection by Parrish. Anderson. And that one goes long. Bulls have gone 2 of 5 shooting here in the third quarter. Iguodala, the pass to Hughes. There's a screen. The dish to Parrish. 6 on the shot clock. He kicks to Robertson for the lead. Morris with the rebound. Lakers have gone only 1 of 6 from the field in the third quarter. Not how they pictured the half start. Cheeks kicks to Anderson. Here's Olajuwon, and he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
And that's an example of willpower right there, guys. I mean, grabbing the offensive rebound and then going back up strong.
And, G.A., in a close game like this where every possession is critical, that could prove to be a very big one.
Boy, it sure could, Kevin. I mean, he salvaged 2 big points for them off that miss.
And here is Los Angeles now after the miss by Oscar Robertson. And another 3 for the Lakers.
A wide-open 3. They need much better communication defensively.
Guys, they're looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Green, no luck. Lakers leading by 6. Here's Cheeks. Aldridge a screen. Cheeks the pass to Aldridge. Dishes it to Olajuwon. Shot is off. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. Hughes kicks to Robertson. Pass to Hughes. That's in, coming off the assist from Robertson. Robertson's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Cheeks the pass to Aldridge. Lakers working the ball around now. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
How about the game for Hakeem Olajuwon? 8 rebounds and 10 points.
Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Los Angeles.
You know, I thought maybe they'd cool off a bit at halftime, but they've continued to bury the jump shots.
Don't overlook the success they've had at the free throw line tonight either.
Two shots.
The first free throw is good. And some changes here for the Lakers. Taj Gibson's checked in for Aldridge. And Jarrett Jack has subbed in for Morris. And Olajuwon drops them both. Bulls trail by six. Robertson dishes to Green. All alone. That's good. Green's got 9 points. Jack with it. He's got 8. They set the screen. He feeds it to Anderson. Plenty of room to knock down the shot. Anderson's got the lead up to 6 now for the Lakers.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
Robertson kicks to Parrish. That's good. And Robertson with the assist. Parrish has got his second bucket tonight.
The defense has not been able to keep the ball out of the paint at that end of the floor.
And I'd be interested to know just how many of these attempts have come from inside of 5 feet.
Here's Cheeks. Anderson passes to Olajuwon. Back to Anderson. From about 16. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. Anderson's got 7 points here in this quarter.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Robertson outside. Cheeks against Hughes. Green with a screen on Cheeks. The shot by Hughes, no good.
And they continue to control the glass.
Guys, I think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
Cheeks against Iguodala. In the corner, it's Jack. Here's the three. Parrish grabs the board. Parrish has got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Good defense by Iguodala.
You can see how much the defense respects him. I mean, they were all over him on that look.
Green by Parrish. Shot off the pick. The offensive rebound. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
And gobbled up that rebound and went straight into attack mode on the putback.
Oof, he is one of the most determined rebounders, Clark, we have got in the NBA.
Yeah, you're calling it right, Kevin. I mean, he gets so many second chance points because of how hard he works to get to the rebound.
Ooh, that's as forceful a finish as you're ever going to see out of this guy.
Well, gee, it adds now to their lead in spectacular fashion.
And, you know, that lead's only going to grow if they're not prepared to defend a little more staunchly than that.
Here is Robertson following the bucket by the Lakers. Releases from 15. Rebound the Lakers. Olajuwon's got 8 rebounds in this game. Cheeks kicks to Jack. Gibson with a screen on Parrish. And Jack, here we go. Passes it to Gibson. And Olajuwon gets it to go on the assist by Gibson. And now it's an 8-point Los Angeles lead.
a chance to check out the numbers for Green, putting up about 18 points per, 12 rebounds, and 2 assists. And just look at those scoring totals. He's been doing what he does best, putting points on the board.
Absolutely. I mean, he has those real natural scoring instincts, the ability to find creases in the defense. Just fantastic.
And the Lakers making a change here. Andrew Bogut checked in for Gibson. Chandler comes in for Anderson. Allen's checked in for Cheeks. And it's Stockton in for Jarrett Jack. Now here's Ellis. That's good. It's Rubio with the assist. Rubio's got 3 assists in the game. Lakers leading by 6. Now Stockton. Feeds to Elijah Wan. With the fadeaway. Allen dishes to Bogut. No luck. They battled on the glass but couldn't knock it down. Here's Ellis. Excellent D from Stockton. LA's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Chandler, the pass to Stockton. Elijah Wan with it. Now Green defending. Green with the block. Here's Bogut. The second chance effort. The shot no good. Great D that time from Iguodala. And Chicago shooting right around 41% from the field in quarter three. He dishes it to Ellis. Kicks to Green. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Green, the screen. Rubio. And he gets the shot to fall after coming off the pick. Rubio's got 7 points in the game. It's a close game here in Chicago. Chandler outside. The pass to Allen. Stockton left side. Pass to Elijah Wan. Shot clock at 5. Here's Bogut. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass.
His hard work on the backboard really just has given them more opportunities to score.
And Rubio kicks to Ellis. Second shot opportunity. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and 2 shots coming up.
Take a look at what Green's done. He has 9 points and a steal.
And we really just need to take a second to appreciate the all-around effort he's put out there today.
Well, the numbers paint the picture, and he has been what we call in my vernacular, you know where I'm going here, guys, stat sheet stuffer supreme.
Oh, supreme. So that takes it to a whole another level when you get supreme in terms of your stat sheet.
And Kellogg-Ease, right? And Kellogg-Ease. Hudson's checked in for the Bulls. And that trip coming up empty, missing both. Stockton with it, guarded now by Rubio. Off the pick, and finished off by Bogut.
And it was the screen there, guys, that freed him up as he ran his man into it.
And then it was all acceleration, GA, to the bucket right after that.
Almost a backboard breaker.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Tony Allen. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game. .151 left in the 3rd quarter. Shot is good in the Los Angeles leads. Cut down now to just 6 points with that basket from Sabonis.
And really, the defense didn't do a lot to fight around that screen on that possession.
Now here's Stockton. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Chandler kicks to Stockton. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot 2. Ricky Rubio picks one up.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouls.
Free throw good, Stockton. Marcus Morris has checked in for the Lakers. That one misses. Bulls trail by 7. Hudson dishes to Rubio. Here's Ellis. The rebound. rebound by the Lakers. Morris has got his third rebound on the night.
It's been a real difficult game for him offensively, and it's costly.
Bogut high post. To the paint, here's Chandler, and you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
Yeah, heads up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Free throw, Chandler.
It's been a strong night for Wilson Chandler. 10 points, and from long range, he's hit 1 3-pointer.
And when it's all said and done, I got a sneaky suspicion he's going to have a few more.
Morris against Hudson. A 3-pointer off the mark.
Physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. That plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Yeah, not to mention what it says on the scoreboard. They're really pushing them around. Straight bully ball. And he's really having all sorts of problems with his jumper.
Yeah, big time. I mean, the words that come to mind, ice and cold and disappearing stroke, all would apply.
5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Morris right side. From deep. Again the miss by Morris.
Frozen. Guy is just ice cold, unable to contribute offensively.
Now, here's Rubio. Ellis, left side. There's Green with the three. Off on that one. And that's going to do it for the third quarter. Lakers lead by 8. And time to step aside quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter. Thanks for joining us, folks. The fourth quarter of play should begin momentarily. Here's Cheeks. And on the court for the Lakers to start the fourth. Aldridge out there with Bogut. Then it's Cheeks. And there's Anderson, and it's Morris in at the three spot. And Draymond Green picks up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game.
You know what? Tried to step in and cut him off, but just didn't get there quick enough.
Yeah, he was one step late that time, Greg.
And here is Los Angeles now. Bogut with a screen on Robertson. Here's Cheeks. Not enough on that one as it misses.
Not pretty. You just got to shake off a miss like that.
Robertson drives in. Good work defensively by Morris. Lakers leading by 8. Aldridge with a screen on Green. Outside Aldridge. The feed to Morris. Clock at 6. Looking to get back on track here. Parrish grabs the board. Parrish has got 9 rebounds now tonight. It's stolen by Morris. Anderson outside. There's the dish to Aldridge. There's the pick to the middle. Off the pick. And Morris with the lay-in. Morris has got the lead up to 10 now for Los Angeles.
Not his best game, but they're still getting it done collectively.
Robertson passes to Green. He kicks it to Hudson. Gets the 3-pointer to fall.
Nice stroke from long range. And if he keeps getting those opportunities, he better take them.
Dishes it to Anderson. Morris against Green. And out of bounds is Chicago gains possession.
And you know what? His mind's playing tricks on him right now because he's not going to live that one down easily.
Andre Iguodala. He's checked in for Chicago. Olajuwon's checked in for Los Angeles. And Chicago has possession. A great fourth quarter, just giving up 2 points. Hughes kicks to Parrish. Elijah Wan with the block. Hughes against Cheeks. Outside Aldridge. Good on the three-point shot. And the Lakers lead by 10.
And that's sort of been the story here today, hasn't it?
And here is Robertson. And he uses the glass on the layup.
And that's not nearly the kind of defense that's going to prevent a player of his ability from scoring.
Pass to Aldridge. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. Aldridge a screen. Elijah Wan kicks to Aldridge. 5 on the clock, and he lobs it up with the rim, and Anderson slams it in.
Phenomenal alley-oop slam right there, guys.
They're taking advantage, Clark, of a team that looks lost out there.
Guys, this one is threatening to get really ugly. And I think taking a time here to talk things over is a smart idea.
One of the things you want to do is make sure everybody is clearly on the same page with the game plan. And sometimes you need a timeout to make sure that's the case.
Quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
I was able to listen in on what Chicago's coach was going over with his team. He was not at all satisfied with their effort level, saying, "We're losing the hustle plays and all the 50-50 balls. We simply can't win that way. We've got to get after it." Let's see how they respond, Kevin.
Now here's Robertson. Iguodala kicks to Robertson. Here's Parrish. Pull the shot a little up, but the bounce goes his way. And he's now got the double-double. 10 points and 10 rebounds. Passes to Anderson. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. To the inside, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will take it. Bulls trail by 8. Robertson dishes to Hudson. A look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. And he gets it to go.
I mean, he's just been brilliant today, guys. And it was the same exact story last time out.
Feeds to Morris. It's Chicago with the rebound. On the wing, it's Larry Hughes. Defended by Cheeks. Hudson. And off the front iron. And in it goes. Now, just a 4-point Los Angeles lead. Kicks to Anderson. It's Aldridge penetrating. That's good.
I mean, he was great in his last game, Clark. And clearly, he has not lost that love and feel.
And there's the pass to Hudson. Pulls it from the elbow. Hakeem Olajuwon grabs the rebound. Lakers leading by 6. Here's Cheeks. Out left to the wing. Aldridge, the pass to Morris. Back to Aldridge. Lets it fly from 18. Again, Los Angeles.
Just no chance for the smaller defender to block that shot.
He's really, really good at using his size to free himself up for those mid-range jumpers. A master at it.
Now, here's Parrish. That's in. That's his 5th field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%. 5 for 7.
Okay, fans, now coming out for your Bulls. Make some noise and cheer them on.
Lakers leading by six. Aldridge with a screen on Robertson. Cheeks kicks to Aldridge. Can't hit. And the Bulls going the other way now. A floater. A nice shot by Hudson. Hudson's got 9 points in the quarter.
Well, I tell you what, I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders. They're not getting the job done.
That's a great point. 10 of the last 12 points they've allowed have come at the rim.
The Bulls have gone 7 of 10 shooting the ball since the start of the fourth quarter. On the wing, it's Larry Hughes. That's in, coming off the assist from Robertson. Robertson's got his 7th assist here tonight. Cheeks against Robertson. Here's Cheeks. Gets to the rim for two with the D all over him. And the Lakers lead by three.
And that's the kind of move that will always pay off, even against tight defense like he was facing on that possession.
Cheeks against Robertson. And he hits it and gets hacked on the play. A three-point possibility if he can convert the free throw.
Well, they were sleeping on defense. The defense really didn't do its job. I mean, a little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint. That's costly.
And at this stage of a tight game, the tired legs really start to show. A defense becomes vulnerable if you can continue to pound it inside.
The Bulls making a switch here. Green's checked in. That one drops. He ties it up. Lakers have gone 6 of 11 since the start of the fourth quarter. Olajuwon with a screen on Robertson. The kick out to Aldridge. Cheeks against Robertson. Lock at six. Cheeks the pass to Olajuwon. Marvelous lead pass, and he throws it down.
Rising high to throw that one down.
Sky high. Fantastic one-hand jam.
Nice way there, guys, to finish up that possession.
Here's Hughes. Olajuwon with the block. Here's Cheeks. He feeds it to Aldridge. Cheeks kicks to Morris. Olajuwon with a screen on Robertson. Here's Morris. And too long on the shot. Chicago's gone 2 for 2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. On the wing, Iguodala. They get it back. Robertson dishes to Parrish. And that one's good. Parrish has got it all tied up now for the Bulls.
Man, he's got a lot of firepower right now. I mean, what a half he's having.
Hakeem Olajuwon again. Olajuwon's got 4 points this quarter.
Yeah, that's a brain freeze right there from the entire defense. Now is not the time to lose your focus.
Hughes, the pass to Green. Lots of room. It's rebounded by Aldridge. Aldridge has got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Pass to Cheeks. To the inside. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Shooting Chicago. Hakeem Olajuwon.
And the first one drops. Hudson's checked in for Andre Iguodala. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Stockton's checked in for Cheeks. Both good from the line that time.
Of course, he didn't have an attempt there in the first half. He's hoping to be a little bit more active and aggressive here and draw some fouls here in the second.
Here's Hughes. He dishes it to Parrish. The feed to Robertson. Second chance shot and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Take a look at what Parrish has done. He's got 12 rebounds and 3 denials. That kind of mix of assists and rebounds is what wins you basketball games.
Clark, it's a rarity when you've got a guy that can just do it as well as he does on both ends.
All right, now, take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. Both free throws good from Parrish. Lakers have gone 8 of 14 from the floor here in the fourth quarter. They set the screen. Now the dish to Aldridge. Trying his luck deep. And it's Chicago with the rebound. Hughes got his third rebound tonight. Good!
And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Greg.
And no good. Had a chance to take the lead. Los Angeles has gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. And Anderson has it in the corner. Hughes with the steal. Green against Anderson. Here's Hudson. To take the lead. No good. Good D by Olajuwon. And Los Angeles guys shooting it well here in the fourth quarter. 50%. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. Stockton kicks to Morris. Six to shoot. It's stolen by Green. Looking to get it going. Here's Hudson. It's good, and they get the go-ahead bucket. Hudson's got 11 in the second half. And what's your take, guys, in the hustle stats for Chicago?
Defensively, they played with a lot of energy, and the steals we've seen are a result of that aggressiveness.
Yeah, I think you also have to give them a lot of credit for how well they've risen up to meet shooters, to challenge shots in this game. A lot of blocked shots tonight.
And look, rightfully disappointed with how they played here over the course of this run.
Yeah, you know, they haven't looked good at all here lately. Something has to change for them, and we'll see what he's got coming out of the timeout.
Left in the fourth quarter. Stockton dishes to Olajuwon. With the fadeaway. Count the bucket. Olajuwon's got the game tied up here for the Lakers.
Yeah, crucial basket there. And as long as they've got that mismatch, big on small, they've got to take advantage.
Well, I don't doubt that they clearly recognize that. And because they do, they're going to continue to milk it.
Green, the pass to Hughes. He kicks it to Hudson. Yes, and the foul. Marcus Morris picks one up there.
Wow, unconscious has he been this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
That's good from Hudson.
No problem for him there. You just know what the result's going to be when he steps to the line in a tight game like this.
Okay, fans, now coming out of the court are your Lovables. Make some noise and cheer them on.
Morris kicks to Stockton. Back to Morris. Wide open. Rebounded by Hudson. Hudson's got his third rebound on the night.
He's having a tough quarter scoring the basketball, unable to help him close this gap.
Green, the screen. Hudson dishes to Robertson. Pass to Hudson. Fires the three. It's rebounded by Aldridge. Lakers trail by three. Stockton passes to Olajuwon. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. It's going to be on Larry Hughes.
You had a foul to give there, but you'd rather not have it cost your team points.
I agree. I mean, you would have been better off using it on the floor and not on the shot. But the foul had to come either way, so it is what it is.
He drops the first one, and that brings them within two here. Olajuwon drops them both. Chicago's gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen. Morris against Hudson. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Morris. ...43 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Hughes kicks to Parrish. Shot clock at six. Stockton with it. Out to the right wing. Here's Olajuwon. Yes!
Just look at what Aldridge is doing.
23 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Robertson against Stockton. Robertson dishes to Hudson. From 12 feet out.
It's in!
Tell you what, fellas, he loves those mid-range jumpers. I mean, that's where he makes his money.
Seconds left in the game.
Here's Elijah One.
Oh, off target.
And he commits the intentional foul.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let him dribble the game.
Exactly. I mean, you got to stop the clock any way possible and hope they alligator arm a few of those free throws.
So the first one drops, and that will put them up by two. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a three-point game.
Yeah, those free throws make things a little more simpler right now. They just have to guard against the three-pointer.
And so the big win by Chicago in a tight game. What a show they put out here at home tonight.
Tremendous work all the way down to the wire. We were just wondering what would happen next. Major drama. And we saw good.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. This is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for tuning in. Now time to head over to the studio where the award-winning Ernie Johnson is with Shaq and Kenny, all standing by. Guys, take it away.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Hey folks, welcome back. Ernie Johnson here with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Let's take a look now as we give our nod to our Jordan player of the game. He found his rhythm in the second half, and there was no stopping him then. He was locked and loaded.
His accuracy from the field was pretty eye-catching. I mean, if he was shooting the ball, it was going in. You rarely see a performance like this with this crazy high shooting percentage. Wow.
Tonight we saw him doing what he does best, control the backboards. With him out there, an opponent can't expect more than one shot for one possession. This guy eats every rebound. They're not giving up any second chances when he's on the floor.
And folks, that'll wrap it up for tonight. We hope you enjoyed the game. For Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith, Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports crew, I'm Ernie Johnson. Have a good evening.